Чайковский's Children's Album is one of the most popular works in the world. Every pianist on the planet has probably played some pieces from this album. The album consists of 24 pieces, many of which are known, loved, and of course played in every corner of the earth. However, among these beauties, there is one ugly Cinderella that no one wants to play and listen to. This is piece number 11, and it is called Russian Song. Even famous pianists, when they have to perform the whole children's album publicly, sometimes just skip this Russian song and pretend that they forgot to play this item. However, you cannot do the same trick if you have to record the whole children's album on record. Because if there are 24 pieces on cover, there should be 24 pieces on the disc as well. At St. Petersburg Conservatory, I was a student of a great musician, Vladimir Nilsen. And one day my teacher signed a contract to record the whole children's album on record. He rented a house in a village, brought his grand piano, and began to prepare for recording. It was a hot summer, therefore windows of the house were always wide open, so the whole village had to enjoy the sounds of children's album for many hours every day. And of course, my teacher worked a lot on this Russian song. He still wanted to find a way of performing in which this song would not be so ugly. And his efforts resulted in the fact that once the villagers gathered near his house. At first they stood in silence, then they began to make noise, and eventually very offensive cries were heard. How can you, professor, teach others when you yourself cannot play even our simple song? I must say that my teacher was very fond of talking with non-musicians about music, and he often gave us examples of how some cloakroom attendant, or a cleaning lady, or a firefighter on stage made very apt, precise observations about music that can be very useful for any performer. And in that case, he of course did not fail to take an opportunity to talk to the playing people about music. And he learned something very interesting from these villagers. But before I tell about it, I ask you to listen to my recording of this Russian song. I play it in exactly the same way as my teacher Vladimir Nilsen taught me to play it. It is a very short song, just a few seconds long, so I play it three times, slow, medium, and fast. And I ask you very much to find out what exactly in the performance of this song could have caused the anger and mass protest of the villagers.
Thank you.
I hope that you listened to my recording carefully, but still did not find anything wrong with either the song itself or with its performance. I believe that many generations have sung and loved this song exactly as it sounds in my fast version of recording. It is a typical folk dance song, no worse and no less beautiful than any other. So why is it that everyone hates this song, including the villagers? What is the reason? The reason of all this trouble is that my teacher did not play the same music that I played for you. At that time, he played a wrong music instead. And unfortunately, today, all the pianists of the world, when they perform the Russian song from children's album by Tchaikovsky, they play the wrong music as well. It happens because Tchaikovsky shifted the bar line in this song one count earlier. And this shift turns this nice, joyful folk dance song into a musical nonsense. And if we play exactly what Tchaikovsky wrote, this music should sound like this. No wonder that the villagers hated this disgusting music so much and couldn't stand it. It is absolutely normal for everyone who really loves music. I can assume that Tchaikovsky moved this bar line for the sake of a very popular in his time idea that music should be as similar as possible to the spoken language. They believed that in this way, music becomes more understandable, becomes closer to the people. I want the music to express the world directly, composer Dragomyshsky wrote. But good singers do not sing colloquial language. They sing music. And all the stresses in musical words are absolutely different from the stresses in spoken words. They are as different are our movements when we are swimming from our movements when we are walking. Different environment requires different movements, different actions, and, in our case, different stresses, different way of pronouncing. And I want to urge all pianists, all musicians in the world, to stop mocking this beautiful, lovely folk song and perform it the way our listeners used to sing it and to love it. Thank you for viewing. I wish all the best to all my viewers.